Alright guys, time to make the final video, the phase 1 of my ROG box build. What do I mean by phase 1? Well, this is how it's going to look for, I would assume, a year before they launch a new graphics card, 3080 Ti, Big Navi. Let's also see what Intel is doing with their GPU cards. So until then, the specs of the system stays as they are. You wouldn't believe how many comments I had until now saying, oh, your build is trash, only GTX 1070, so much money spent, and my PC is stronger than yours. Listen, it's not about right now, it's about the broader picture. First of all, I want to buy a new monitor, and currently I'm looking at a 34-inch ultra-wides with a high refresh rate and about 5 million pixels. And to be honest, even 2080 Ti is too weak to drive that, and there's no point in buying a 120Hz display if I can run it at 80Hz, so GPU will have to wait. But back to the build. So I got this new ROG Helios case, it came about a month ago, well packed. It's in this large ROG bag, which is kind of a nice touch. Definitely well presented, and what a beauty it is. There has been a great debate online about how expensive it is, but come on really, £260, there's cases that are more expensive than it, and I wouldn't have any of them. And if you're looking at the price point, let's say from £200 to £260, they all look so mediocre to that I would rather chip in extra just to get a Helios. And it's a case. You invest in a good case once, and it can serve you, well, I don't want to say a lifetime, but you get the point. So it was time to put it all together. My old and trusted Ghetto ROG box had to go, replaced by this, and comparison. Spot the 10 differences. So I prepared everything I needed for the swap. I got the solution for the removal of the thermal paste, compressed air to fight with all the dust, a couple of PSU extensions that I will go into details later. I picked up the EK Vardar RGB fans as well that I will use in the exhaust, and HSBC RGB splitters when and if I buy more RGB fans. My old HDD for extra storage, couple of screwdrivers, my trusted MX4, and anti-static band to not burn this shit to the ground. But first I had to clean everything. I have been running this thing panel off for like a test bench for a while, and it had to be cleaned properly. That's why I'm so glad that Helios comes with these three removable dust filters. First, I took apart the GPU, cleaned the heat sinks and the fans, removed the old thermal paste, and applied the new one. Then it was time for the AIO, and oh my god, just look at this filth. No amount of compressed air would deal with that, so I had to actually use a toothbrush to scrub all this dust off it. Oh, there we go, much better. Took apart the PSU as well and got it nice and clean. Now is the time to install everything, put the motherboard in, and try it out the PSU extensions. The thing with the Helios is that it's so high, your PSU cables won't reach the top corner. Well, they would reach, but they create this abomination of the cable management in the back that I opted to go for the cabling extensions instead. And yes, I know I don't need to use both cables, I could run fine with just one. It's not pulling that much power, but there's really no downside in using both. Just spread the load on two different cables and have them run cooler. But in reality, you don't need to use them both. If you're going this route, make sure you have the correct extensions. Check the AWG rating on your PSU and extensions you buy. My Thor comes with 18, and extensions are the same 18 AWG. It stands for American Wire Gauge. I don't know, just look it up. I heard that 16 are better, but don't quote me on that. Also, I heard that anything about 18 should be avoided, but do your own research, people. Next, I put the hard drives in, added RAM and M.2 module. Then all the rest that I forgot to take the pictures for. So let's start it up for the first time, shall we? Thank you. and the peel. Oh yes, that you might have seen already previously. The other reason why this video was delayed is that I ordered the ROG terminal as well, and frankly I don't really care about RGB, but my OCD kicked in and every time I looked at the case and that empty stand, it just pissed me off. It's like a missing puzzle piece, I just had to get it there to complete the look. So that arrived a couple of weeks ago, and for like a week I ran it outside of the chassis connected to the TV for the Aura Halo effect. If you're not aware, the Aura Halo effect is where you take the three included RGB strips, attach them to the back of the TV or the monitor, sync them up with the PC, and you can get this synced glow effect, sort of like how Philips Ambiglow is working. I'll include some videos here, but the quality is shit, but you get the point, and if you're interested in this technology, check out the other YouTubers. They do much better reviews of this than I am or care to do. Also, you can sync it up with the Aura and have it to match rest of your system. Here's a couple of pictures of that. After I had my share of fun with the Halo effect, it was time to get it into the system. Here's a couple of pictures of that. And for the three RGB strips, they are all daisy chained together and connected to the one of the terminal ports. And I've got the front Helios panel connected to the terminal, as well as I have the only 5 volt addressable RGB connector being used by the Thor power supply. And the final step was to do some bloody cable management. I straightened out and combed the motherboard connector. It's not perfect, but it will do. And I also did the GPU connector. Now that one I really liked how it turned out. You see there's a cable pass-through on the PSU shroud that you can put your GPU cables through, but I don't really like that look. So what I did is I ran the GPU cable under the card and exited it through the motherboard opening. And I have one of the GPU sag brackets to hold the card and the other one to hold the cables, and I really like how it turned out. Now the back of the case, I spent a couple hours on it, and granted it's not perfect, but it does the job. I can close the lid, and by lid I mean the lid, the plastic piece of cover that covers the cables before the glass goes on. And here you can see the full effect, why I use those cable extensions. Here's a couple of pictures of builds, how they look without these, and how they look with the cable extensions. Alright G, that's a lot of information. Alright, I'll include some more pictures and videos here for you. If you have any questions, drop me a message below. I'm 905, signing out.